mistaken?
Yes, two questions.
La première, c'est...
First of all, with the microphone, please. Sorry, the speaker's microphone went off. Okay, thank you.
How come you,
with this institute, you cannot convey your message? You compared it to Microsoft. You said it was not the best possible technology, but they do play a leading role. I guess that Monsanto, with the same dimension, doesn't manage to do this. I also believe that the topic of this meeting is global governance. We are talking about food security. Now, what is the role of global governance in this respect? The agricultural policy, European or French or American, are they ready to accept an emerging agriculture in emerging countries? I, for my part, would like to reply to the first question. Jean, perhaps you can answer the first one. Let me simply remind you that the world agricultural land is 1.6 billion hectares, so that's 130 billion in GMOs. And why is Monsanto always being pointed at? Because the, well, the yes, that's the role they usually play. But I have no specific reply, but perhaps one of the possible replies would be to say that the consumer has or sees no direct advantage in GMOs. The agriculturists, so the farmers or the intermediate levels will see a benefit from it, but there is no direct output for the consumer now. Obviously, the concerns regarding or stemming from the German or French consumers were fed by a number of catastrophes that I don't want to dwell upon, and perhaps it's also insufficient information. Obviously, Greenpeace was financed, has been financed by the German lignite producers before the fall of the Berlin Wall, and in order to enable the Soviet Union to overcome its drawback in the nuclear field. But when you look at this, it is surprising to see that three major academies, the Swiss, French, and US scientific academies, published a report on Chernobyl, and you can find it on the WHO website. When this report is being presented, there are some 10 journalists attending, and when you have a report by Greenpeace, there are some 500 journalists. And of course, the World Press takes up the report, and we don't know whether Chernobyl is going to entail some 4,000 or 5,000 casualties over 20 years. And in the meantime, there is a distortion of competition in Europe, and I believe that there's also that we believe less and less in progress, especially on the leftist parties. Okay, I'm sure that we can go on and on, because nutrition scares or food scares are very popular. I think that whenever we discuss agriculture, either it's been in some organizations, it's being discussed as at FAO, where this is an important discussion. FAO, as you know, is possibly one of the worst UN agencies, perhaps like UNESCO, and UNESCO at least deals with monuments. FAO doesn't really deal with, not even with that, and nobody can use its statistics. Now, I'm not talking about the World Food Program when I talk FAO, because the World Food Program, this is one of the best UN agencies, but these are specialists in emergency cases. They are by far the best. These people are capable of handling logistics that are absolutely unimaginable.
que Monsieur Umarov disait,
so when Mr. Umarov said you need to increase the emergency stock, that is certainly needs to be done. Now, President Wadov of Senegal said you have to dismantle FAO, now perhaps FAO being chaired by a Senegalese, maybe this was an insider story, but unfortunately FAO is part of the problem. There is another organization, WTO. Now, obviously, WTO's vision, you know that you heard Mr. Umarov, the Doha rounds need to be brought to a conclusion. And for a very long time, the low prices known at the end of the 20th century were linked to the fact that Jean was quite right on this, that these were residual markets. Nobody was selling at a profitable price because there were enough subsidies or aids or systems in various under various shapes and forms, such as deficiency payments, etc. Now this period is coming to an end, and nothing today. And because Lamy keeps repeating this, nothing today within the framework of the WTO agreements, the Marrakesh agreements, prevents a country from protecting its agriculture. However, this is a simple detail, but I think it is the key to the problem. Agricultural policy, when you look at it from a historical point of view, there are two possibilities. Either the consumer is behind it through prices, or the taxpayer who can do so through direct subsidies. Now, in Europe, it was a consumer. In the US, it is the taxpayer. Look at a third country, an African sub-Saharan country. The consumer doesn't have any ways and means, and there are no taxpayers. So how are you going to finance this assistance? This is where international aid and assistance is important. And the Bill Gates Foundation today is financing price guarantees to the producer in a number of African countries. Now, this was a very summary answer. I know that there was